Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1st and 2nd Samuel, 1st and 2nd Kings, 1st and 2nd Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther and Job, Psalms, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, and the Song of Songs, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, Hosea, and Joel, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, and Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, and Malachi.
Let your word be your lip, be a light unto my feet. Let it shine on me, let it shine on me. Let your word be your lip, be a light unto my feet. Let it shine on, shine on.
Galatians, Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, take a breath. 1st and 2nd Thessalonians, 1st and 2nd Timothy, Titus, Philemon, Hebrews, James, 1st and 2nd Peter, 1st, 2nd, 3rd John, Jude, and Revelation.
Come on, let's take it to the nation.
Love your word, be your lip, be the light unto my feet. Let it shine on me, let it shine on me. Love your word.
Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1st and 2nd Samuel, 1st and 2nd Kings, 1st and 2nd Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther and Job, Psalms, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, and the Song of Songs, Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, Hosea, and Joel, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, and Nahum, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zechariah, and Malachi.
Let your word be your lip, be a light unto my feet. Let it shine on.
Hi, Penny and Dorothy. Good morning. All right, shout out to first grade from Miss Shelley. I love that you guys are saying hi to each other. Hi, Sophia. Hi, Sophia. Hi, Brooklyn and Ian. Who else is on? Hello, Harper. Hi, Emily and Allison. Kira and Ryan. Oh, my goodness. I miss you two so much. Miss Julie is on. Good morning, Miss Julie. Who else is here? Hi, Lillian. Good morning. Oh, Abigail's like, get ready 7 minutes. You guys are ready. You're on time. Hello to my favorite triplets in the whole wide world, Elizabeth, Joseph, and Alexander. I'm so happy you guys are here. Good morning, you guys. Who else is here? We have Matthew Pick. We have, oh, my comments are moving. Sorry, guys. We have Matthew. We have Samuel. We have Lillian again. I see. Ooh, Matthew is here. Who is that? Hello. We're so happy you're here. We have Riley and Declan. Good morning, you guys. I'm so happy you guys are here. I know you guys moved even further away from church. So if anything, live stream church is such a blessing. I'm so happy you could join us. Hi, Miss Emily. Our team Lee. She's online. Hi, Aiden and Faith. Good morning. Hi, Kate and Micah. Hello, hello. Hi, Hannah and Cheeto. Oh, my goodness. I don't think I've met you guys. I hope I get to meet you guys soon. Miss Liz and I, we've been doing family one-on-ones through Zoom. And it's been so fun. This past yesterday, I had it with Anna and Bella. I hope Hannah and Cheeto, I get to meet you guys through that. Make sure to ask your parents to look at their email for that, okay? Hi, Miss Jackie. Good morning. I love our teachers. I mean, we have the best teachers in the world. Hi, Nolan. Hello, hello. Who else is here? We have Allison Kim. She says she is ready. Girl, I love it. I'm ready. You're ready. We're all ready. Oh, Mr. Seabass, he's going to be commenting down today. So make sure to say hi to Mr. Seabass. Hi, Jonah and Sophie. I love it. I love our KKC siblings because I just love imagining them sitting together and worshiping and then doing the body worship moves all together. I love that. Hello, Anthony. Hello, Marcus. Hello, hello, Kendall and Mason. Good morning, you guys. Who else is here? Hi, Jaden. Hi, Jaden. I know Jaden lives also really, really far. So what a blessing live stream is. Who else is here? Mr. Ibby. Mr. Ibby's online. Hello. Hi, Mr. Nathan. He says good morning to third graders. Who else is here? Aiden C. Good morning. Hi, Aiden. Is that Aiden, like Connor's brother? Oh, my goodness, Aiden. I miss you so much. Who else is here? Tarang and Junyoung. Good morning. Good morning. I miss you guys already. Hi, Cece. Such a big girl. Got to see her last week during the Kinder Zoom as well. All right, I'm going to keep going. I miss you guys so much. Hi, Daniel and Ellie, you guys. I got to Zoom Daniel and Ellie's family this week, and it was so much fun. I hope I get to Zoom all of you guys as well. Sunshines. I love that. I think that is one of my favorite, like, names that you guys have been putting on our website or this live stream. Kayla and Kyle, good morning. So punny. I love puns. Hello, Maze. Lucas and Karina are here. Good morning, you guys. Hi, Colin. Hello, Colin. I'm so happy you're here. Who else is here? Annette and Charlotte. Good morning. We have another KKC sibling pair. Who else is here? We have Aaron. Good morning, Aaron. I'm so, so happy. Who else? Who else? Who else? Who else is here? Kaden and Arden. Kaden and Arden, I know you guys are joining us recently, right? I'm so happy that you guys found our church. So happy you're here with us at KKC. Welcome to our church, Living Hope Kids. Hello, Megan. Who else? You guys, thank you so much for being so patient as we figure out live stream stuff. Mr. Caleb and Mr. Mike are doing an amazing job. So thank you so much for being so patient, you guys. Hi, DJ. Hello, hello. Who else is here? I'm seeing a lot of repeats, so I'm going to try to find Evelyn. Hello, Evelyn. Hi, Elise. Hi, good morning. Big first grader. Who else is here? Charlotte and Matthew. Hi, you guys. I miss you so much. I'm so happy you're here. Hi, Joshua. Good morning. Hi, Mrs. Rachel. I got a big shout out. Hello, you guys. All righty. You know what? Oh, Miss Clara is on. Hi, Brendan. Oh, my goodness. Good morning. I'm so happy. Is that Brendan, our kindergartner? Oh, I love it. Hello, hello. All righty. I am going to end around here. I am so happy each and every one of you guys are here because I know that that means you're ready to worship. I'm so happy that we can worship together every Sunday morning because it's a time that we devote to just worshiping God, learning more about Him through the Bible, and just praying together as a church family. All right, before we start with body worship, please have your Bibles ready. Make sure to go grab it. I'm going to give you 7 seconds. I'm going to get you 7 seconds to go grab your amazing Bible, your basic instructions before leaving Earth, and you're going to turn to John 3:17. So have like a little bookmark ready. John 3:17, go get your Bibles. I'm going to give you guys 4 more seconds. All righty. Let me know if you have your Bibles ready in the comments. I hope you do. I'm so excited for today's message. Miss Liz, as always, has an amazing word to share with us. Let me pray before we start our body worship. I really hope you guys all stand up and worship with us. God loves to see us worshiping with our hearts, our minds, and our bodies, you guys. So let's body worship together, okay? Let's pray. Father, thank you so much for this amazing Sunday, God. I love Sundays at 10:45 because I just know that we're all doing the same thing together as one church. And we're sitting in front of our computers, our laptops, our iPads, our TVs, ready to receive your word, ready to pray, and ready to worship you. Father, you deserve all our praise. You deserve all our love. You deserve all the glory, God. So today, would you just receive it all? Father, I pray that you would open up the hearts of our Living Hope kids. Father, prepare their heart for worship. Can't wait for you to see all of them and smile down on them, seeing them worship you. We love you so, so much. Thank you so much for today. We love you. In your precious name we pray. Amen. Let's worship.
You are above every other. Your love amazes me. You created every beautiful color for everyone to see. I want the world to know. I want my life to show just what your love has done for me. Praise God, 'cause only you deserve it. I want the world to know, I want my life to show just what your love has done for me.
is my faith. This is my focus. All of my days, I know where my hope is. I live it loud. I shout the chorus because I'm no. I know where my hope is. I live it loud. I shout the chorus because I know, oh, you're always for us. And even when it's hard for me to see,
come back. This is KKC. You guys, I'm having so much fun. I hope you had an amazing time body worshiping along with us. Let us close this time of worship with offering. If you have offering, I know some of you guys even save your own money to give to the Lord. You can go ahead and give that to your parents. And parents, you can give online on our website, livinghopecc.org. At this time, let us close with the Lord's Prayer. Let's pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our debts as we also have forgiven our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. All righty. I just love being here, you guys. My heart is so happy. I was looking at the comments too and talking with Mr. Seabass and everyone here. You guys seem so happy today. This Sunday is such a beautiful Sunday. Am I right? Can you give me a whoop whoop in the comments if I'm right? Isn't today such an amazing Sunday? I'm so happy. My happy levels are like super, they're so high today. Anyway, let's get on with the announcements. A couple announcements for you guys. So first, next week is CIA Sunday. We're changing things up like we mentioned last month. We are doing Let's Chat with God. That means you still wear your CIA shirt. Kindergartners, I know you guys haven't been able to get your KKC CIA shirts yet. Please wear something yellow or bring something yellow and we'll live stream together. Also, another announcement is, before we go to another announcement, I'm going to dismiss the kindergartners right now to their Zoom. Kindergartners, you are dismissed to go join Miss Tiffany, Mr. J, Miss Nikki, Miss Jane, Miss Jennifer. Mr. J has an amazing message for you guys, so go ahead and go to your kindergarten Zoom right now. And lastly, you guys, we had such an amazing in-person service for our third to fifth graders. I got to see Joshy, I got to see Lukey, Lindsay, Ashley. I got to see so many of our friends this morning. If you're in third grade up to fifth grade, we welcome you guys to register for next week. Watch this fun video for more information.
Hi, Living Hope Kids, it's Miss Liz here, and I have a very special announcement for those of you that are in third to fifth grade. Starting this Sunday, we are inviting all of you to come back to church to hear your very own children's ministry message in person. You heard that right, in person. Here's how it's gonna work. You're gonna ask your parents to sign you up for the 9:30 service portion on Eventbrite. At 9:30, you and your family are gonna sit in family worship together, hear the sermon together. Then after the sermon at around 10:20, we're gonna invite all of our third to fifth graders to quietly walk to Chapel 1 to hear the children's ministry message given by either me or Miss Rachel. Parents, you're totally welcome to join your child for this portion. It's completely optional, up to you. For those of you that can't make it or just wanting to continue watching our online service at home, don't worry, we're still continuing our live stream online worship at 10:45 a.m. with small groups immediately after that as usual. Once again, for those of you guys that are wanting to come and are in third, fourth to fifth grade, please don't forget to register online at Eventbrite. Please know, you guys, that whether or not we are able to see you this Sunday, know that we are thinking of you, praying for you guys, and we really hope to see you guys soon. Bye!
You guys, I'm so excited to hopefully see all of you here. But for now, we really want to invite the third to fifth graders to join us. We have our space. We have our KKC Chapel back once again. We have chairs from like 8 feet, 10 feet apart. We're super safe. Everyone will be wearing masks. You get to hear mine or Miss Liz's message in person. I really hope that you're able to come. Third to fifth grade in your small groups, your friends who are here will share with you how that was. I really hope that makes you feel comfortable enough to come join us. I really, really hope that you can. At this time, we're going to watch the Gospel Project video in preparation for Miss Liz's sermon. I hope that you guys all listen intently. Please only comment in our comment section if Miss Liz is asking a question or if you have something encouraging to say. I love reading all your comments, so please make sure let's be wise with what we write. Let's get ready for the Gospel Project video. See you next week.
Many years before God's people were taken to Babylon, God promised the prophet Jeremiah that the exile would last 70 years. Then, God would bring his people back home. God always keeps his promises. Cyrus, king of Persia, had taken over Babylon. God gave Cyrus an idea. Cyrus said, "Let all of God's people go back to Jerusalem so they can rebuild the Lord's temple. Give them gold and silver and animals. Give them gifts for God's temple." The exile was over. God's people were free to go back to their homes. God's people got ready and their neighbors gave them gifts. Silver, gold, and animals and other expensive things. Zerubbabel and the high priest led God's people back to Judah. They had been away for 70 years. Many of the people were born in Babylon. They had never seen the land God had given their parents and grandparents. In all, thousands of people went back to Judah. They settled in their hometowns and set up their houses. Then the people met together in Jerusalem to rebuild the Lord's temple. First, the priest rebuilt the altar in the same place it used to be. They followed all the laws of God for building. When the altar was finished, they offered burnt offerings to God. The people also obeyed the law about special celebrations. They had a festival like God had told them to do, and they made sacrifices to God. Then God's people gave money to stonecutters and carpenters who would work on God's temple. They paid people to bring cedar logs to Jerusalem. Mm. Finally, when everything was ready, people started to work. They laid the foundation of the temple. The foundation was important. It would make the building strong. When the foundation was finished, the priests put on special clothes and the people praised God. They sang, "The Lord is good. His faithful love will last forever." Then the people shouted and praised God. They were so happy. The foundation of the temple was complete. Not everyone was happy, though. Some of the older people remembered what the temple had looked like 70 years ago, before it had been destroyed. They cried. The noise of the crying and shouting was so loud that the people could be heard far away. Zerubbabel led God's people back to the temple to rebuild it. The temple was the place where God met with his people on earth. Jesus came to earth to rescue God's people. One day, Jesus will return to restore a greater home for all of God's people, and we will spend eternity with him.
All right, good morning, boys and girls. So really quickly, you guys might be kind of confused what that video was about. You know, we were watching it and we realized that was not the video that we were supposed to send you. I think that was like an Old Testament video and we're on New Testament. So we apologize if it was a little bit confusing, but we know that the Bible, everything in it is true, everything in it is good. So hopefully you were still able to enjoy the video that you watched. But before we get started, I do want to make sure that my mic is working. So I'm going to ask Mr. Caleb really quick. Mr. Mike, is it working? It looks good. Sound check. Mr. Sebastian, is my mic working? Yes? You cannot hear anything. All right. Hopefully, we're going to wait a little bit till my mic is working because I want to make sure everyone is able to hear this message today. It is working? Perfect. All right. So you guys might be wondering, why do I have presents in front of me? You guys, starting September, it is an amazing time of the month because starting September all the way to December, it is birthday season for my family. So in September, it's my dad and my dog's birthday. In October, it's me and my sister's birthday. My birthday is on Halloween. In November, it's my sister and my other sister's birthday. And then in December, it's my mom's birthday. And I'm pretty sure my grandma's birthday is like sometime after that. You guys. And then after my mom's birthday, 2 days later, it's Christmas. So you could probably imagine how much money we're spending on gifts. We're buying gifts. We're wrapping gifts. We're giving gifts. We're getting gifts. Then we're buying more gifts because of Christmas. And then we're getting more gifts because it's Christmas. It's just a crazy gift season. So I brought some gifts here today to show you guys some of the things that I love to receive when it's my birthday or Christmas, and some of the things that I will give to my family members. So I want to show you guys really quick. Dun, 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 dun. I'm going to open the big one. If you guys can guess what's in here, I don't know if you can hear it. If you guys can guess, put it in the comments. But in this bag, this is a board game that I love, and many of you guys might have seen it before, but it is dun, 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 Pie Face. For those of you guys that do not know what this game is, it's super fun. You basically get whipped cream, and you might get pied in the face. It's safe, though, because whipped cream is, like, soft and fluffy. But I would love this game when I was younger, Pie Face. I'm going to put this in the big box. All right, in this box, what could it be? Let me see. Dun, 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 dun. What's in here? Ooh, okay, you guys. So in this box is something that I love to get every first day of school. I told my mom and dad, I need to get this when school starts. It's not a backpack, but it's actually a lunchbox. This is a Fortnite video game lunchbox. For those of you guys that like video games, you might like this. But this is a new, very new lunchbox. It still has the tag on it. But I would love any type of new lunchbox on the first day of school. So I'm going to put that right over here so you guys can see it. Or actually, I'll just put it back in the box. Let's clear the table. Let's see, what else? Ooh, and this polka dot bag. What do I have in here? Oh, this is for my artists out there. It's a new washable paint set for those of you guys that love to paint. You know how exciting this is, but every time you paint, what do you need? Bum, ba, da, dum, bum, bum. You need paintbrushes. So I loved getting new paint and new paintbrushes because I could make a pretty picture and give it to my friends and family. Sometimes my mom would actually frame my picture and put it on the wall so everyone can see what I painted. All right. I love gift season. This is the best. Okay. And in this bag right here, last but not least, what do you guys think it is? Dun, 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 dun. This is called kinetic sand. It's not regular beach sand, but it's kinetic sand. So it basically, when you play with it, it kind of feels like slime. But you know what's super cool about this one, you guys? This one, it smells like vanilla cupcake. And this one smells like chocolate swirl. It actually says scratch and sniff. So I think if I scratch it, I can smell it. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, it smells so good. It smells like Hershey's chocolate bar. Let me see this. This smells like vanilla ice cream, very strong. Awesome gifts. Woo, that was a lot of gifts wrapping and opening. But you guys, as much as I love gifts, you know what's really sad about mostly any gift that you get? It does not last forever. My new lunchbox, once I spill, I don't know, orange juice or tomato sauce or drop it in the mud, whatever happens is gonna eventually get dirty and I have to eventually throw it away. Why do we like getting a new lunchbox every year? It's because we want a super sparkly, clean new one. My new paint set, once I use it all up, the paint bottles are gonna go in the trash. This pie face game, as fun as it is right now, one day I might, I don't know, accidentally break it. It might get rusty. The pieces might fall off or break and I can't play it anymore. What else did I have? My kinetic sand. You know, someday it might get hard or the sand might fall all over the floor and my mom says, vacuum that up and throw it in the garbage. No more kinetic sand in the house. All of these gifts will eventually fade away. Today, boys and girls, we're gonna learn about a very special gift, this one gift that lasts forever. You see, God gave us the greatest gift. If you guys look up at my next slide, it says this, that God gave us the best gift, and that gift is his son, Jesus. You see, boys and girls, we learn from the book of Genesis, which is the first book in the Bible, that as soon as sin entered the world, we were separated from God. Sin separates us from having a relationship with him. Everyone is sinners, which means everyone is separated. Do you think that makes God happy or sad? Sad, of course. He does not want to see us separated from him because he loves us all so much. When he looks at, I'm trying to think of some of our friends on the screen. When he looks at Charlotte, and when he looks at Matthew, and when he looks at Aiden, he says, I love you so much, and I want us to be together, and I want you to be my child, and I want to be a happy family. I want to live and be and walk with you forever, but sin separates. But God, from the very beginning, had a plan to make a way to bring us back to him. Even though we sin, he says, I'm going to make a way to bring my people back to me. And the only way that can happen is if someone or something dies as a punishment for that sin. But he loves us so much, and he said, I don't want them to die, and I don't want them to be punished. So instead, you guys know this story, a very true special story. One day, he decided to send his one and only son to take the punishment for all of our sins, and anyone who believes gets to be with God and live with him forever. You see, boys and girls, God gave what was most precious to him. When you guys are wrapping gifts, let's say it's like your sister's birthday, Do you give her something that's super, super old and rotten and you're like, I don't need this anymore. I'm just going to give it to her for her birthday present. Or do you guys find something in the trash and you're like, it still smells kind of okay. I'll just put it in the bag and give it to them. No, you want to give your friend and your family member the very best gift. And that's what God did. He gave the most precious thing to him, his one and only son, to come to earth, to be born, to live a perfect life, and to eventually die and to rise again so that we may be saved, all who believe in him. At this time, I want all of us to open up our Bibles to John chapter 3, verse 17. Hopefully, you guys have this verse opened up already because I know Miss Rachel told you multiple times to have it ready. Mr. Sebastian put it on the chat. So hopefully you do. If you don't, it's totally okay. Feel free to look up at the screen right now, okay? But John 3, verse 17 says this. For God did not send his son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. And my next slide says this, that God sent Jesus to save us because he loves us. You see, boys and girls, last week we learned about how John the Baptist came to prepare the way for Jesus. Today we're learning that God sent Jesus not to prepare a way for someone, but God sent Jesus to save us. He had a plan, and Jesus knew what the mission was, that I'm going to be born, I'm going to come into the world, I'm going to die, I'm going to rise again, and anyone who believes in this truth gets to be a child of God forever. You see, boys and girls, this gift is so special because, like I said earlier, it never disappears, it never fades away, it never spoils, and it's here to stay. It's an eternal life gift. It's an eternal promise that all who believe, even after we die, get to be reunited with God in heaven forever. And you know what's the best part about gifts? Is that it's completely free. What if, okay, I'm trying to think of another friend in our chat. Trying to think of who commented today. Serena, I remember you commented. If Serena says, Miss Liz, your birthday's on Halloween, I have a perfect gift for you. And she wraps up this box and she says, I put a big pretty bow on it and this is for you, Miss Liz, but you have to give me $10. And I'm gonna say, what? Serena, it's a gift. Why do I need to give you $10? And she says, Miss Liz, I spent my very own money on it. You know how many chores I had to do to get $10? You need to give me $10 back, and then I'll give you the special gift. And I'm going to say, Serena, that's not what a gift is about. A gift means that it's free, that you're giving it to me, and all I need to do is receive. And that's what this gift is all about from God too, you guys. That is completely free. If you look at my next slide, it says this. It is a free gift that all we need to do is believe and receive. So boys and girls, at this time, I want you to think about if you received this gift, if you want to receive this gift, or in the future, if you desire to receive this free gift that God gave us, his one and only son, to die on the cross, that those who believe in him will be reunited with the Lord forever. If you guys want to make that decision to accept this gift today, please tell your small group leaders. They are ready to hear you at 11:30 on Zoom, and they will pray with you. And guess what? This gift, like I said, it will never fade. It is the greatest gift that we could ever, ever receive. And I want to encourage all of you guys to share this gift with others. Yes, it's amazing that we get to keep it, but if you have someone in your family or at school that don't have this gift and don't know about Jesus, please let them know and tell them that this gift is for them too. That God sent Jesus some 2,000 plus years ago to be born, to save, and to bring us back to him. Let's pray at this time. God, we just want to thank you, first of all, for giving us a gift that lasts forever. Lord, we love you so much. We thank you, God, that even though sin separates from us, you decided to make a way. You made a way for us to go back to you, and even after we die, can live with you forever in heaven. So God, we pray that we would believe this, that we would accept it, and that we would share it with others as well. We love you so much. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, boys and girls, right now it's 11:24. It is not quite 11:30 yet, so you have 6 minutes to go to the bathroom, get a snack, make sure your computer is charged, and be ready for Zoom at 11:30, all right? All right, but actually, boys and girls, I was just told that we do have the right Gospel Project video, so we're going to show that right now. Good thing we have a little bit extra time. We're going to show the right Gospel Project video afterwards, take a quick bathroom break, and be back on at 11:30 for Zoom. Bye!
Mary and Joseph lived in the town of Nazareth. During the time Mary was pregnant, the Roman Emperor Caesar Augustus announced that everyone needed to be registered for a census. Since Joseph was a descendant of King David, he and Mary traveled to Bethlehem, the city of David. While they were there, the time came for Mary to have her baby. Mary and Joseph looked for a safe place to stay, but every place was full. So Mary and Joseph found a place where animals were kept, and that is where Mary had her baby. Joseph named him Jesus. Mary wrapped the baby tightly in cloth and laid him in a feeding trough. That night, some shepherds were watching over their sheep in the fields near Bethlehem. Suddenly, an angel stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were terrified. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. I have very good news for you and for all the people. Today, a Savior, who is the Messiah and the Lord, was born for you in the city of David." Then the angel said, "You will find a baby wrapped tightly in cloth and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a whole army of angels appeared, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and peace on earth to people he favors." When the angels left and returned to heaven, The shepherds decided to go see if the angels' words were true. They hurried to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the feeding trough. Then the shepherds went and told others about the baby Jesus. Everyone who heard about Jesus was surprised and amazed. Mary thought about everything that was happening and tried to understand it. The shepherds returned to their fields, praising God because everything had happened just as the angel said. The birth of Jesus was good news. Jesus was not an ordinary baby. He is God's Son, sent to earth from heaven. Jesus, the promised Savior, came into the world to deliver us from sin and death.